Hello and welcome to this Eldari painting video. In this video, we're going to show you how to paint a Shroud Runner. Now, we'll be using a mix of both classic and contrast methods, and we're painting the model up to battle ready as well. Now, before we begin painting, the first thing we'll need to do is undercoat the model. And as you can see here, we've used Mechanica Standard Grey for the crew and Mephiston Red for the actual Shroud Runner itself. Now, the first colours we're going to be applying are going to be base coats. Now, I'm going to start off with the cloaks, and for this, we'll be using Deathwald Forest. After that, we're going to move on to Mephiston Red. That's going to be for the armour. Then for the leather details, we're going to do two colours. Firstly, for the belts and boots, we'll be using Dried Bark. And then after that, for the pouches, we'll use Mournfang Brown. But first of all, let's start with that cloak. I'm going to get a little bit of Deathwald Forest and put it on our palette like so. A little bit of water, not too much. Just don't want it to be too thick and goopy. And as always, I just like to spin my brush a little bit just to get a decent point to it. Then we're ready to start picking out that cloak. So just take your time, and now don't worry if you start getting this on other areas like the armor and stuff, because we can always tidy that back up at a later point. Now that we've applied the green, what we're now going to do is move on to the body armor. For this, we're using Mephiston Red. Again, take your time, and in some places you might want to do a second coat. Now that we've done the red details, we're going to move on to the dark brown leather details. So this is boots and straps. And for this, we're using Dried Bark. Now that we've done those dark leather details, we're now just going to move on to using Mournfang Brown for the pouch or holster. With that pouch now picked out, what we're now going to do is move on to applying the rest of the base coats. We're going to start with a Baden Black. This is going to be for the weapons as well as the faceplate. Then we'll use Korax White for the helmet, then Retributor Armor for any gold details such as the trinkets you'll see on the models, and then finish off by picking out those lenses and gems using Thousand Suns Blue. But first of all, let's start with those black details. I'm just going to get a couple of dollops of a Baden Black, just like so. And just a little bit of water, not too much. Mix it together once I'm happy. And loaded that brush up, we're ready to start picking the weapons out. You've got the weapons, but don't forget the faceplate as well. With the guns and the face mask now done, we're just going to move on to the helmet, and we're coating this with Korax White. Again, I've thinned this down. I'm going to do multiple thin coats to get a nice smooth coverage. There we are, with the white now done, we're now going to move on to the gold details. Now for this, we're using Retributor Armor, and all we're doing is just picking out a bunch of those gold details. If you're not sure, just check the box art for details. There we are, with the gold now done, what we're now going to do is move on to picking out the gems and the eyes. Just take your time, and if you find you get any on the gold, just tidy back up with Retributor Armor. With the gems and lenses now picked out, what we're now going to do is move on to applying some contrast. So I'm going to start first with Militarum Green, and I'm going to thin this down with some contrast medium. Once we've done that, for the red details, we're going to get some Flesh Terrors Red. We're also going to thin that down with a little bit of contrast medium as well. Then for the leathers, both the dark and light, we'll be using Basilicarnum Grey. Then for the white helmet, we'll use a bit of Apothecary White. But first of all, let's start with Militarum Green. So what I'm going to do is use my brush as a measuring tool. I'm going to get three paintbrushes worth of contrast medium to apply that to the palette. Give it a quick wash and a wipe, and then I'm just going to have one paintbrush of Militarum Green and just mix that together. So it's not too neat, but it'll still do all the flowing and go in those recesses that you need it to do. So once I've loaded up my brush, I don't want to load up too much because I don't want it pooled everywhere. I'm just going to start applying it to the cloak. So we're just keeping this to the camo cloak. Again, just take your time. Subtly run into those deeper recesses and just pull away from the top parts of the folds of cloth. That'll give you some instant highlighting and layering with minimal effort. There we are, with the Militarum Green now done, what we're now going to do is coat Flesh Terrors Red thinned down with Contrast Medium. And this is three parts Contrast Medium, one part Flesh Terrors Red. Now that the Flesh Terrors Red has been applied, we're going to move on to Basilicarnum Grey. So this is for all the leather details. I'll also apply a little bit onto the gold as well, just add a bit of definition in those recesses. Now that we've coated the leather and the gold, we're now going to move on to Apothecary White for the white helmet. So again, just apply that If you do find it pooling, use your brush to soak up any excess. And there we are with the Apothecary White now dry. Our Ranger is finished. So what we're going to do now is we're going to move on to the Shroud Runner itself. Now I'm going to start by picking out any black details using a Baden Black. For the silver areas, we'll be using Ironhand Steel. And then for the console, or any gems if you find them, we'll be using Thousand Suns Blue. But first of all, let's start by getting a Baden Black. So all I'm going to do is apply a couple of dollops to the palette. A little bit of water just so it's not too thick and goopy. And then, as is always key, give your brush a good spin to get a nice point, and then we're ready. So the first thing I'm going to start on is actually start picking out the leather seats. So take my time. If you do find you're making a mistake, you can always tidy back up with a little bit of Mephiston Red as well. So on the actual bike itself, you're going to be like getting little bits between the veins. There's also the handlebars as well. If you're not sure, just check the box art. Now that we've picked out all those black details, what we're now going to do is move on to the silver details. So you've got a little vent at the front, but I've also got the exhaust at the back. So I'm just going to start on the exhaust and whip my way around. Now that we've picked out the silver areas, we're going to move on to the console. And for this, we're going to be using Thousand Suns Blue. So all I'm going to do is just start picking out some of the buttons, as well as this area here. You might just want to do a couple of coats of it. And there we are, the console picked out, our base coats are done. So what we're now going to do is move on to applying some contrast. Now the first thing we're going to do is build up a camo effect on that front, as well as add some depth to the red. Now for this we'll be using Flesh Tearer's Red. And for the camo effect to start off with, what we're going to be doing is thinning down with contrast medium quite heavily, so 5 parts contrast medium to 1 part Flesh Tearer's Red. And that will give us a nice mottled effect. Once that's dry, we're going to do that again with the same mix, just add a little bit more depth to that camo pattern. And then after that, we'll get Flesh Tearer's Red straight from the pot, again, building on that camo pattern, and then finish off with some silicone gray for the silver details. But first of all, let's start with that first mix. So what I'm going to do here is get myself 5 paintbrushes worth of contrast medium, 4 and 5. So I'm happy with that, give the brush a quick wash, and a quick dry, and then 1 paintbrush there of Flesh Tearer's Red. Mix that together like so. And all I'm going to do is try not to overload it too much. And we're ready to start applying that to the front. So what we're going to do here is, as you can see, we've got a nice smooth area. So all I'm going to do is just start stabbing that with my medium shade brush. And what you'll find is as you start stabbing it, and it might dry a little bit here and there, it will give you a nice little mottled effect. And as we start going through and adding more coats, you'll see those mottles appear with a bit more definition. And again, don't forget to run this in some of those deeper areas on the actual Shroud Runner itself. There we are with that first coat now dry. You can see the hull at the front is slightly darker than the rest of the bike, and also there's a lot of blotching effect. So what we're now going to do is do the same again. We're just building up the darkness of that and also that blotchy camo effect that we're aiming for. And just take your time and just keep stabbing that brush. There we are, with that second coat now applied, you can see those blotch effects are really starting to build up. So what we're now going to do is use Flesh Tearer's Red straight from the pot and just add a bit more emphasis to them. So all I'm going to do is on some of those darker patches, is just start doing some little dots here and there and start generating a nice little camo patch. Now it's not 100% the same as the ones you see on the box art, because that's very geometric shapes, but it's a really nice, quick and easy way of getting an awesome camo scheme with very minimal effort. Now that we've applied that Flesh Tearer's Red straight from the pot, you can see you've got a decent camo scheme coming up. You can always add more if you want to, but I'm happy leaving it at that. So what we're now going to do is move on to applying some silicone grey to the silver details. With all those contrasts now applied and dry, what we're now going to do is move on to basing the model. Now we're going to start first by applying some Sterling Mud. Once that's dry, we're then going to coat over that with some Agraff's Earthshade. So first of all, I'm going to get my trusty texture tool, and all I'm going to do is just scoop a load of that out like so. So I've got enough on my actual scoop. This is the large side first, and then I'm going to just start placing that down on the base, as you can see here. As I get closer to the stem, just so I can be a bit more accurate, what I'm going to do is use the smaller side of the texture tool, just so I've got a bit more accuracy going on there. And again, just keep going back, loading up, and then just flatten it onto your base like so. Once you've applied it all, you just need to leave it for an hour to dry. That texture now dry, all we're going to do now is apply aggregate surface shade over it, just add a bit of depth so it looks like a horrible swampland. Now this is probably going to take about 30 minutes to dry as well. Once that's done, just paint the rim of the base in a colour that matches your force. For this one, we're going to use Steel Legion Drab. And there we are, with the rim now painted, our base is now done. With the texture now dry and the rim of the base painted, I've also glued the models to the Shroud Runner and it is now battle ready. Now there's just a couple of things to remember when painting this model. Firstly, when using base paints, try and be as neat as you can. Remember, the neater you are, the better the end result. And if you do make any mistakes, you can always tidy back up at a later point if you want to. Also, when using any shades or contrasts, try not to overload your brush as it can quickly run out of control. If you do find that happening, just use your brush to soak up any excess. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this video. Hope you enjoy painting your own Eldari Shroud Runners, and we'll see you again soon. Bye bye.